Petty Officer Shane.
Can he sing?
Can you say it?
Mr. Patton, please.
Come on. Been around the world twice. Talked to everyone once. There ain't nothing I can't do. No sky too high, no sea too rough. Learned a lot of lessons in my life. Never shoot a large caliber man with a small caliber bullet. Anything in life worth doing is worth overdoing. Moderation's for cowards. I'm a lover. I'm a fighter. I'm a UDT Navy SEAL diver.
Listen up. That is a clip from a new movie, Lone Survivor, which is due out Christmas Day. It's based on the true story of how only one of four Navy SEALs survived a mission in Afghanistan. It is the Hollywood version of the Navy SEALs. Former Army combat veteran and photojournalist Greg Matheson knows firsthand all about the real Navy SEALs. There's Hollywood there, sure, but there's a lot more, way more layers than just the Hollywood. And he's been given some incredible access to the SEALs and the entire U.S. Navy Special Ops. The result is this, and I'm going to have to work it because it's 9 pounds. This new book, pretty remarkable, United States Naval Special Warfare, U.S. Navy SEALs. And if you can see the glistening icon in the middle there, that thing is 14 karat gold plated, and it's what makes this book also very special. But what's inside really is what's remarkable. And Greg Matheson joins me now. I was looking through this book, and I was struck right away by the photos that I feel like I've always seen, sort of the photo ops that the government's given us, and then everything else that took me into the layers about the Navy SEALs. What don't people know about them that you got and you put in this book?
Well, my colleague Dave Galley, a photographer, and I worked on this thing for 6 years. We got behind the scenes to see things people don't see around the world. The SEALs wanted to put this out to show all of Naval Special Warfare, not just the SEALs.
Yeah.
And it goes in depth like no other book has ever done before.
So the access that you got is crazy. I want to just draw everyone's attention to this picture of Zacharias Moussaoui, the 20th hijacker, when he was being led off to the Supermax. There you are in what I could only have imagined was a top secret operation. I don't understand how you got there.
These aren't SEALs, actually. These are U.S. Marshals.
Oh, these are Marshals.
But this isn't a chapter that deals with terrorism.
Okay.
And the Marshals have hired me in the past. That's part of the trust I've had with the government over the years that allowed me the access to cover the SEALs.
And some of the other pictures that I found so remarkable, there was one picture that really stood out. It was a coffin.
Correct.
And at first I wasn't sure what I was seeing. It just sort of looked like a belt. But this is a wooden coffin. And those are the trident pins that the SEALs wear on their lapels. Yeah. I'm only guessing that this is a fallen comrade, and they each took the pins off of their lapels and jammed them into the wood of the coffin?
This is a recent tradition that's happened in the past number of years here, where they actually, the SEALs who attend, yes, take their trident pins off their uniforms and pound them into the casket before it gets lowered into Arlington Cemetery.
Some of the other things that I was looking at, and I'm a bit of a geek nerd and a gear nerd, and when I look at these things and I see these guys, very few people would ever jump out of anything, let alone a chopper like this, wearing flippers, but it just shows you, I mean, I don't think there's a better way to say it than the badass nature of these guys.
Not only the flippers, but the thing is, the guy up here has got a minigun, and he's firing about 60,000 rounds a minute down on the ground for suppression fire before these guys, they're actually going to drop the Zodiac below them and then jump into the water, get in the Zodiac, and insert
this
onto a beach.
It's hard to sort of make it out, but this is the Zodiac strung underneath
the
chopper.
Thousands of shells falling down off this helicopter right now, and this guy's firing.
And he's just a couple feet away from that remarkable ordnance delivery mechanism. Another thing that you showed, which I didn't know that we ever were allowed to see, was this kind of thing, the future of warfare. Some of the, I don't even know what to call this. Is the Sea Lion? Is that what
they call it? This is called Sea Lion. It's actually a prototype that they've been using for a number of years. It's a platform. The nose actually goes through the waves. Instead of a boat going over the waves, this goes right through the waves. It actually submerges down, and this isn't classified. You can get this off of a site somewhere out there now.
Except that I'd never seen it before. Is that just because I'm an idiot?
It submerges almost like a submarine about a few feet below the water, and there's a little teeny bulb on the top there with the camera.
There are a few pictures of this in this book, and when I first saw it, I thought that there's no way that that isn't classified. But you're saying that we do have access.
Carter Rock built this,
difficult to get access. So about the access, you started working on getting this kind of access? Because this is the most secretive group out there. I mean, it is really, really difficult.
Well, I've been covering the White House for 30 years, Pentagon. I've been a correspondent covering the military overseas, all the wars. I was a producer for NBC during the Iraq War early on. We snuck into Iraq 3 months before the war started.
And but your work to try to gain this kind of access started back in, what, 87?
Yes. Actually, that back then, the admiral who was in charge of the Navy SEALs retired and became one of my writers, along with other SEALs in here. It's been reviewed by the Navy. The Navy has wanted to put this out to show the entire concept of the Navy SEALs.
Let me be really specific about when you say it's been reviewed by the Navy, and you're very candid about this in the what you write at the beginning of the book. There's a lot of digitization. There's a lot of things that have been carefully extracted digitally from these photographs to protect not only the law, but also the identities and the safety of a lot of these.
We even took the serial numbers off the guns.
Really?
So if a guy's holding a gun in there, we've gone and enlarged it as much as we can and took the serial number off the gun.
So there's no one in jeopardy.
You can't track the gun, where it was manufactured, where it came from, where it is.
And as much oversight as there was, it does really still feel like a remarkable peekaboo. By the way, special fella writing the opening of the book. He's never done it before. Who is it?
President George W. Bush.
Wow. So once again, because it's 9 pounds, and I nearly didn't research the rest of my show because I was so engrossed in this thing. It's awesome. It really is. It's an excellent, excellent piece of journalism.
It's available on Amazon.
Will you sign this for me?
Yes, it's available at Barnes & Noble's and at sealbook.com.
And it's expensive, but not as expensive as I thought.
Well, it's actually pretty inexpensive. Yeah, it's inexpensive
considering
for a book that size,
The gold seal. All right, listen, Greg, thank you. It's nice to meet you.
Appreciate it.
Great
thank
work.
You. Happy holidays.
Wonderful to see this stuff.
Okay.
Happy holidays.